I don't know how to say this without sounding like an absolute idiot, but I lost my passport. Now, I know what you're going to say. You've lost your bank card, you've lost your phone, you've missed your flights, you've been in hospital, all in the last year and a half of travelling. Actually, the last year of travelling. I've been to 12 countries in 10 months. I only have one more country to reach by the end of the year, and that has made my target of 13 countries in 1 year. So what exactly happened? Well, I was an idiot. I got drunk. I'd been in this comfort zone where I'd been training hard. I'd been sleeping properly for once in my life. I had family there that were feeding me, looking after me, and all these amazing things. And I thought, you know what? I'm going to go and treat myself to a couple of beers downtown, get some fish and chips. Those two beers turned into a night out. I met these Canadians that were lovely and invited me to their hotel room to pre-game, pre-drink, as I would call it. And they had Jaeger bombs, they had beer bongs, they had these little green tea drinks, Canadian Club, everything. I mixed them all so much and ended up into a bit of a state. But it wasn't until after the club that I realised I was a state and didn't get into another club because I'd lost my passport. And it's really strict on ID there. But I ended up getting into a fight with these people. These people were being really nasty, and I was being very defensive. It was just a stupid, drunken situation. I ended up falling on my elbow. So you can imagine, the next day, I was feeling like utter crap. I woke up having this weird situation the night before, and I really didn't like myself. I didn't like where I was at mentally, emotionally, physically. I felt anxious. I felt depressed. Alcohol is a depressant. We need to remember that. But in moderation, it can be good. And the people that you're drinking with are everything. So Erica and Nano, the family I was staying with, they really did know, because they have great intuition that way, that I was not in a good place. So they came in and they asked, this was at 3 p.m. I hadn't left the room. And they said, Daniel, what's wrong? And I told them, and they were very supportive. They didn't laugh. They were very much, you know, in agreement with me that it was not a good situation and that I should learn from this, as it was a mistake. It was, you know, I make a lot of failures and I'm going to hold my hands up. And that's why I do these videos. I like telling you guys when I'm wrong, because I want you guys to know that us as humans, we are not all perfect. We are not all these divine creatures. And I know that you guys are all like, you can be social justice warriors and you feel like you're right. A lot of people, when they're given their opinion on things like politics, all these things in society, a lot of the time, most of you aren't even doing it because you're right. It's just that you want to feel right, you know? You want to be able to say, I'm right, you're wrong, I'm good, you're bad. And I feel like a lot of people are very critical of everyone nowadays, very judgmental of everyone. So I've kind of gone against the grain and I'm saying, hey, look, I'm not perfect. I'm showing my mistakes. I'm showing my weaknesses and my failures because I'm not afraid to show that. And I think that a lot of you guys should do that as well, because we're not perfect. Anyway, so the next day I felt terrible and I woke up feeling like death. And so I thought, I'm going to go and do something good. So I went on my way to this beautiful surfing town called Tofino, which is very famous. And there's a beach there called Long Beach. You might have seen it from the movie Planet of the Apes. We went through this ancient forest. And it's like something out of Twilight. I'm sure Twilight was actually filmed in a lot of the places in on Vancouver Island in British Columbia. So yeah, look at this, it's just amazing. Tofino. Now, Tofino was just incredible. It was everything that I thought it would be. It's the kind of place that made me feel like I wanted to just be a better person again. Oh, I won't let you go. Believe it. thing that made this trip much more amazing was that I actually made this mistake. Now, mistakes can be bad, but they can also be very good. And my relationships with the family and everyone that I met there from that point onward were much more meaningful. I trusted them. We'd opened up. I'd cried. I'd been upset. We'd shown emotion. You broke down that barrier, you know? A lot of us have these barriers up all the time, including myself. But with this family, I just opened up. And with the friends that I met there, I opened up. I showed my vulnerable side. And they showed me theirs in return. It was like a trade-for-trade thing that just didn't even seem to be any bother. No currency, nothing like that. It was just my love to your love, and their love comes straight back. That's as humans what we should do. If we're all like that more often, the world will be a better place. So as I took that boat, that ferry over to the British Embassy in Vancouver to get my emergency passport, which really didn't cost that much at all, I was looking out over the water, really, really just taking in that sea air, and it was another part of the adventure. You know, things are going to happen. They may cost a little bit of money, but you pay that price for the mistake you made, and then after that, it's all over. There's no place I'd rather be. Sunsets in Vancouver Island, they're pretty incredible. You should definitely check out Vancouver Island for the sunsets as well. Part of the journey, spending the longest I've ever spent with anyone else other than my own family, I had to say goodbye. Now, it wasn't a goodbye as such, because I will be going back and I do love them so much, but that saying goodbye to them was so hard, because you have no idea how cute and how much love and how much attachment that you grow for these, the family and the kids, especially the kids. They were just so cute. I just couldn't get over it.
Let's see, which one is it?
Parrot!
Oh, it's a parrot!
That's my favourite.
Eli, what's your favourite butterfly? Are you sweating? It's very hot in here. The giant Atlas moth. Wow.
So, I had a long flight home, but I stopped off in Calgary. Now, Calgary even made more of an adventure, because when I arrived in Calgary, it was the record snowstorm in 30 years in October. They were calling it Snowtober.
We'll see a sun cloud mix 5 on Thursday, sunshine 8 degrees on Friday, and with a sun cloud mix 5 on Saturday.
So I am downtown Calgary right now. My flight is at 6 p.m. The meet and greet is supposed to be at 1 p.m. I'm actually going to do it. Very risky move, but I'm going to see at least for like 20 minutes, 10, 15 minutes, and then try and head to the airport. I have to be at the airport for 3 p.m. Traffic has been building up. It's kind of, if you look around me, there's just snow everywhere. And it's the middle of October. Merry Christmas, everybody. So we've had a great day. I had to leave it early, but I will be back here in November to see all these beautiful people. And you're all getting in the vlog. Woo! Wait. Yay! So sadly, because of the weather, I had to cut it short at the meet and greet, but I posted and some people had actually driven 6 hours and they couldn't get to the meet and greet in the central location, so they actually came to the airport. And thank goodness I met them. I think they would have actually killed me if I didn't get to see them after driving 6 hours. But they were awesome and we sat in Juga Juice, we shared stories, we did motivational conversations. And then we also got on a buggy and they took me all the way to the terminal. How nice is that?
Yeah, it's treacherous, it's icy. It's
6 hours you drove.
Yep.
6 hours. And now, thankfully, we all met in Juga Juice.
It's awesome. But you know, it's been so much fun. It has.
It is. It's been wonderful.
Look, you got to come. You got to finish your midterm.
Yes, I finished my midterm.
And then she rushed over here. Probably like a mad lady like us. That's awesome!
Hey, we're getting a little ride! Yay! Say hello, Ivan!
Hi there!
Too funny.
How are you, sir? Thank you for the ride.
Thank you. Awesome.
What's your name?
Louis.
Louis.
Hi,
thank you, Louis.
No problem.
Oh! I'm Simon Jackson. Ooh, I am for real. Never meant to make your daughter cry. Apologize a trillion times. I'm sorry, Miss Jackson. Ooh, but I am for real. Never meant to make your daughter cry. I apologize a trillion times.
At this point, this is one of my longer vlogs, so I hope that I'm not boring you to death. But here we go. I ended up going to London. So I got on a flight from Calgary to London and a guy got kicked off the flight just because he wouldn't take his earbuds out for the safety demonstration. What an idiot. He also even said the words, if you knew who I was, you wouldn't be kicking me off this flight. I wanted to turn around and just be like, look, son, doesn't matter who you are or who you are, nay, you are an arsehole. And it's great. I feel great. I've already ordered a new passport. I'm already getting stuff done. I'm making this video right now. Yes, it's long. I hope you don't mind that. If you want to help me out on my journey, you can help me out by either going to my Patreon, which I'll put in the link in the description. My Instagram is Daniel_Ewan_Henderson. It's going to be amazing. Please make sure to like this up. Give me your comments. Give me your thoughts. What did you think? Did you think I was a bit stupid? Did you ever do it? What's your biggest travel nightmares? Please comment below. But the moral of this story is don't lose your passport. Anyway, I love you guys.